Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. So today I am going to discuss about pseudocode. Already you know P is a silent, so that's what we call it is a pseudocode. If you remember, already I have discussed about algorithms flowchart. So I have shown like a various type of diagram of this flowchart and how to write it. So pseudocode is similar to flowchart, but it's not a pictorial representations. We can represent with some keywords and normal English language, but both are high level. If you are talking about algorithms, so that is a deeper level concept, right? So if you are new in my channel, I'll suggest you subscribe the channel to get all the latest technology related to Java, data structure, microservices, and other stuff. You can check out also my playlist for beginner. So let's see what you will get from this tutorial. First of all, this tutorial will going to cover to write a pseudocode from beginner level to advanced level. So in first topic is what is pseudocode, and then I'll discuss about why that pseudocode came and what are the alternatives of pseudocode, and then some statements and mathematical operators that are being used by the pseudocode, and some special keywords and conditional iterations, and how to write a basic programs using pseudocode, and finally I'll show some example. So this is my agenda. So first point is, what is pseudocode? If you remember, in flowchart I have discussed it's a pictorial representations to provide a solutions of particular problems or tasks, right? But pseudocode, it's a and same thing, informal high level descriptions of a computer program or algorithms. You can see high level descriptions. It is written in some symbolic code, means with the help of some keyword and mathematical operators, which must be translated into any programming language before it can be executed. But if you remember, if you are actually thinking like pseudocode represent all the business logic, not like that, but it's a symbolic representations that will give you the overall pictures of that particular solutions of a algorithm. So that is basically pseudocode. And then second slide, why this pseudocode? You can say also the benefit of the pseudocode, right? So pseudocode basically omits the programming details. So let's say example, suppose a client is asking for, you need to develop one microservice that is related to activity change, okay, and it will keep the track of the every employee activity. So that time you have to either draw a flowchart or you have to write a pseudocode. So it's basically independent of any programming language syntax, and it's any declarations of variable. So based on that customer requirement, you will write a high level code of this program. Code here means this pseudocode. And second thing is, it's based on any human readable language. Suppose if you are talking about Java, Clojure, Kotlin, Python, Ruby, so that is means you have to learn that syntax, like how we are learning French language, English language, Tamil, Telugu, Bengali. So similarly, so this is easily understandable by human language because it's based on in common English. So you don't need to understand the Java or C sharp. So it's a programming language independent. And third things, as it makes things very easy to understand, so that is means any human being easily picked up and easily can write the pseudocode. That is related to second point again. And fourth one, as it is not dependent on any programming language, so you can implement easily, okay. And fifth point, writing for a complex code might be a result more time. So instead of these things, when your project has been initial phase, if you write a pseudocode or flowchart, so that will give you that more clarity instead of sometime what happened that customer is constantly changing that requirement. So if you write the code and it will waste lots of time, then again you have to change it. So writing pseudo code is a better options, right? So our third slide is related to alternatives. So what are the things is there, I mean, that is similar to pseudo code we can consider. So we can consider, as I said, flowchart. It's a similar things, but it's a pictorial representations. Also Dracon chart is there, and UML. So that is unified modified language. So that is UML diagram, sometimes we said it. And also activity sequence diagram. So we can consider those are the alternatives. So using these diagrams, so those things are basically pictorial representations. But only pseudo code, it's a common English language, you can say it's a normal statement. So easily we can actually use these things alternative of pseudo code in order to represent our complex or critical project at the initial level or high level. Okay, so what is a statement? In case of pseudo code, whatever we are actually writing in a line, so that is actually called statements. That is not directly understandable by the computer, but it's easily understandable by the human being, right? So that each and every lines what we are writing, so that is called as a statement in pseudo code. Now our next part is mathematical operators. In order to perform certain operations, so you need to understand what are the mathematical operators, or you can say symbols is there. So with this arrow or this colon equals to symbol, you can assign any value to a particular variable. So this is basically assignment. So I want to assign 2 pi r value to c, particular c variable. So I can represent like this way. And for comparison, so this is less than, this is greater than, this is less than equal, this is greater than equal, this is not equal, and this is equal. So like a similar to our normal mathematical, right? And arithmetic also same things, but this symbol will give you remainder and quotient value mod. And if you are talking about floor or ceiling, so that time you will use, this is actually floor function and this is ceiling functions. What is the task? Floor functions, it will give you that nearest integer number, and ceiling function, it will give you the highest integer number. I mean, suppose you have a 7.3, if you use that floor, you will get a 7. Suppose you have a 7.8, if you use that ceiling, you will get a 8. Okay. And this is a mod functions, you can see. And logical, and or, and summations and product. This is for summations and this is for products. So those are the example. So how we can represent any mathematical operators with the help of pseudo code. This is a normal representations like our mathematical. Okay. Now next, what is keyword? As I said, keyword is more important, right? In order to write a pseudo code, you need to understand certain keyword. Like in flowchart, we understand certain picture, diamond shape, or it could be a normal rectangle shape. Similarly, in keywords, whenever we have to start our particular program, so that time we'll use a start. In case of flowchart, we used, it's a oval shape symbol, right? So if I need to take any input, either I can use the input, and also you can take a read or get. In order to display any data, I mean show the result, so you can use either print, display, or show. And in order to processing, means compute, calculate, or determine, so these things you can use with the help of this keyword. And you want to set any values, so that time you can use the set or init. And if you want to do increment that particular value of a variable, so that time you will use increment, and for decrement purpose you will use that decrement. So likewise, there are few more keywords are there, but those are main keywords. So next, what you need to understand. So if you are working in some programming language, so you know there is a some conditional keywords is there, like a if else, switch case, and then nested if else. So similarly in pseudo code, we can represent if else, but we'll write a normal English language, like if you are happy, then smile. So if is basically your keyword, and then this is actually condition. You are happy, this is a conditions. If you are happy, and then outcome should be you have to smile. And how you represent end of this if statement, you have to use that end if. Got it? And similarly, if you want to use that nested if else, then that time you can use if you are happy, then smile, else frown. And you are actually going to end this if else statement, so that's what you are using that end if, right? So it's a normal, like how in programming languages we used, but the thing is we are not following any syntax here. We are not using any curly bracket or let's say fast bracket. Those are not mandatory. Mandatory is what we are going to represent. If these things happen, then this is my outcome, then end if, like this way. Okay. So another conditional is case. So normally we used in switch case. If you talking about Java, C, C++, C sharp, they have a switch case. This is a branching statement. How we will do? So you have to take a input, let's say color, case 1, case color of. So if this is a red, print red. If green, print green. If blue, print blue. Others cases, print, please enter a proper value color. And how you will close that case? With the help of end case, like a end if. Similarly, first of all, you are taking the input with a case, these portions, and then we are validating with a, it's a red, then do this operation. It's a green, do these operations. Like same thing, it's a blue, do these operations. If not matching, then others is there. So you should pin this one. So this is comes under conditional. So switch and case. Similarly, for and while loop is there. So for and while basically iterations purpose, right? It's a similar, like if you take an example, so first of all, it should be my for keyword, that is mandatory, then every month in a year. Then what I am saying, compute number of days, and then end for. So it's a looping system. So this is first month, second month in a year, third month in a year, and then compute number of days inside that for loop, and then we are actually ending. Okay, so while is same things, but you have to give that preconditions before that while. Okay, so you have to give some variable names. Here I have given that variable name x is equals to 1. You can see it's a simple written. You can actually use that assignment operator here. While populations less than limit, then I am saying compute populations as populations plus birth minus date. So this is a normal things. So normal populations would be what? Population should be number of persons is getting birth today and minus number of persons is dying today. So it should be populations plus birth minus date. So finally, I am doing with a end while. So similarly, like a end for loop, end if, so we can use end while. So this is basically while loop structure. If you have any problem, I am going to share this slide. Just go through it. So I'll also let you know. So how we can use this one with the some example. So now functions. So similarly, each and every programs, if you are talking about any functional programming, so there is a functions, and object programming, there is a method. So function is similar to method, right? So how we can define a functions with the help of pseudocode. So you have to use that function, this keyword, and then your function name and argument. Your function's name is what? Clear monitor. Okay, this is your function name. What you are pass in is nothing. Direct, then what you are doing direct in the operating system to clear the monitor. Okay, and then out, pass out is nothing, then end functions. So that is means you have to emulate a functions to call in pseudocode. We can easily call the keyword. Suppose you want to call this clear monitor, these functions, you have to use that call keyword clone space then your function name. So that is means you are calling that particular functions. So you can see these functions is similar. You are not using any parentheses or any curly bracket. So what you are using functions, space function name, what you are actually passing in, and what operations you are doing in this middle of things, and then what would be your output, pass output, and then you are going to end these functions. Okay. So this is also about functions. Now program. Suppose you can see in C++ program how we will start hash include studio.h. In Java, we put that package name, that import statement, then class, public class, like that. But in order to pseudocode, if you want to make, okay, this is my program. So you use that program keyword and then space your program name, and then whatever things you will write inside here, and then you will use that end. Okay, and similarly in pseudocode you can represent the exception. Suppose in your particular problem or program there might be occur some exceptions, and how you can represent that exceptions, you will use that begin keyword and end with the end keyword. So in between that your statement should be there. Your statement, let's say you are calculating or computing some things, and then you will use that exceptions. And when that exceptions type, then when the exceptions type means when you are actually going to handle these exceptions. Suppose if you are dividing some numbers by zero, integer number, so that is means it's not possible, right? So that time you have to handle the exceptions. So that is means when. So this is the situations when some integer number is divided by zero, then a statement to the handle exceptions. So what you will take the action in order to handle this type of exceptions. Similarly, if you want to use multiple, then you can use that when another exceptions type, some null pointer exceptions, or I can give an example of Java arithmetic exceptions, and then you have to provide the statement how to handle that exceptions, and finally you will end up with end, right? So things, but again, how to write a pseudo code. So if you consider any flowchart, so it's a similar. You have to start thinking about the problems, then you have to break the problems, and then you have to organize in a sequence manner. And in order to write the pseudo code, you have to understand that for each, and then if else statement, and this case, and functions, how actually we define the functions using the pseudocode. So, and few more keywords, and with the help of operators, finally you have to write the pseudocode. So let me show you one common example. Okay, so in that left side picture you can see I have basically one flowchart. In flowchart, what I represent, I have to calculate the perimeter of a rectangle. So what is the theory? 2 into first bracket length plus width. So this is the definitions of how to calculate the perimeter of a rectangle, right? So what I'll do, I'll start with the help of this oval shape, and then I have this flow, and then I am taking input. So that's what it is, actually parallelogram. So I am taking one input, that is enter a number, then enter number B, and then I am calculating A plus B plus C, and then I am actually printing out. So similarly, if you want to do like a this way in particular pseudo code, so what you will do? So in that case you have to do a start, as I said, a start. Then you have to take either, I said, read or anything you can take, read A, then you have to do read B and then C. How you assign? I said you can assign like a this way, C equals to A plus B and finally print C and this is end. So this is basically my pseudo code. So how to calculate the summations of two numbers. But again, so if you need to calculate the perimeter, so enter the length I, enter the width W, compute perimeter. So you can, I said like you can use that compute keyword. So also you can use that assign. So it doesn't matter here, you can use still compute. So compute perimeter equals to 2 into I plus 2 into W. So that is length plus 2 into width. And then display the perimeter of a rectangle. You can write anything, perimeter of a rectangle or perimeter. So this how actually we write the particular pseudo code. If you remember, so this is a enter is keyword, compute is keyword and display is keyword. So instead of enter, you can also take, as I shown, read, also you can take as a input, right? And if you want to assign an initial value, so that time what you have to give? So as I said, initial value set, set L equals to 5. So like this, also you can use that init L equals to 5. So this is a initialized value. So like this, we can actually calculate the perimeter of a rectangle and we can represent with the help of pseudo code. So now we'll see. Well, so this program is written is completely C++. The program is, you have to find out the Pascal triangle. So you know what is the Pascal triangle. If you doesn't know, I'll show you in my different tutorial. But how we are calculating, how we are writing the pseudo code, I'll show in this example. So you can see, like I have taken one number, that is integer number. I am taking the value of this integer number, okay, and then I am checking if that number value is less than 1, then I am actually throwing, are you gone mad, this is not possible, it should be greater than 1, and finally I am closing the program. If not, then what it will come to, this statement, I am starting from 1, I am checking up to number and I am increment the value of I plus plus 1. And similarly, inside that for loop, I have taken another for loop, that is nested for loop. So I am taking k equals to 0, k less than I, k plus plus, and I am finally pin the star, and finally I am closing the for loop. So two for loop I am closing and this is return. So Pascal triangle is nothing but it will print this triangle, it's a star format. So if I represent this one in pseudo code, how it would be my pseudo code? If you remember, I said I am taking one number, so that is means input variable number in first line if you see, and second what I am doing, second actually I am checking if the number is less than 1 or not. So I am checking if number is less than 1, then display error message like whatever we have shown, are you mad, and exit the program, same things we did, end if, right? We have done that if a statement end. Now I have used that for I equals to 1 to number, right? A step 1, so a step 1 means it will increment by 1, and do means it will continue, and inside that I use for k equals to 1 to I. If you remember, I have done is I, right? K equals to 0, k less than I. So same things I did here, okay, and incrementing 1 and do. Then display, what I said, actually I am printing here. This count function basically print function in C++. So I am printing here. So that is basically display star. Then what I did, I closed this for loop, right? One for loop I closed. So similarly here, if you remember here, I done one close for loop, end for, then display the line break. So I am giving next line. So this is a next line pinned. So that's what I have used, that next line pinned, and then I did end for loop. Okay. And finally, I am actually exit from the program. So if I need to exit from the program, I use that exit from the program. So I have to use this particular keyword here. And if I need to give some program name, so what I need to do, as I said in the top of these things, I'll use that program space this my name. Program name is calculate Pascal triangle, and then finally in last portions I'll use that end. So this is all about related to pseudocode. So still, if you are facing some issues, so just let me know in the comment sections, I'll try to guide you. But frankly speaking, in order to write efficient algorithms, so first of all, you need to learn from the basic flowchart and how to write the pseudocodes and UML diagram. This is more important for a developer or tester. It's a programming language independent. Whether you are working in .NET, Scala, Python, Ruby, Java, C, C++, doesn't matter. This is common to all. So I'll suggest you to learn these things, and always I'll be there. Thanks for watching my video. I'll see you next tutorial. Bye.